This time last year, Li Bei was running from one international business meeting to another. But because of the pandemic, her work as a freelance interpreter has dried up. She's turned to online teaching to make ends meet.
I find it quite challenging and depressing for me sometimes, but I would be reminded by people around me and to understand that it's not just me, it's actually everybody, and there are people being hit harder than me.
When China's leaders gather for the National People's Congress on Friday, the slowing economy will be front and center. Local coronavirus infections have slowed to single digits, and manufacturing activity has resumed. But shoppers are staying home, and investment is down. Shuttered small businesses are a common sight, while closed borders have hurt the tourism and conference industry.
This is Beijing's biggest convention center, and during this time of year, it's usually overflowing with crowds of people attending international trade shows and conferences. But because of COVID-19, all of these events have been cancelled, and this venue has remained closed for months.
Millions have taken a pay cut or are out of work. The official unemployment rate is 6%, but analysts say in the second quarter, the real figure could be closer to 18%.
Unemployment is closely related to social instability. And for Chinese government, the number one jobs this year is to create enough jobs to absorb those unemployed migrants and the upcoming new university graduates.
This year, nearly 9 million graduates will enter the worst job market in China's recent history. And it's not just students who are worried.
The epidemic has had a deadly effect on the economy. Ordinary people are less willing to spend money.
Leaders attending the Congress are expected to announce further economic stimulus measures and a growth target for the year. Li Bei is hoping virus-related travel restrictions will be relaxed so international events can resume. Until then, like millions around the world, she's staying home and standing by. Katrina Yu, Al Jazeera, Beijing.